Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my guest at this time, granting his first interview since being stripped of the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Please welcome Daniel Bryan. That young man feel awesome. This is incredible to see. Good luck.
That won't work, Daniel.
Expect you back in a WWE ring.
Well, this is where I've got some bad news. I don't know when I'm going to be back. Unfortunately, the strength hasn't come back in my arm, and they're talking about maybe doing another surgery. But I promise you, I will be back. And when I'm back, I am going to be better than ever.
Daniel, describe your feelings being here tonight and knowing that in just a mere few hours, someone's going to climb a ladder and become the new WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, obviously, I'd rather be coming down here and actually wrestling in front of these great people. And I'd much rather be walking down here with the WWE World Heavyweight Championship around my waist, rather than watching these titles hang up here and watching six other guys try and scratch and claw for something that belongs to me. But I've been fighting an uphill battle ever since I started wrestling. And it wouldn't be a Daniel Bryan story if I didn't have a few setbacks. But I'm going to come back and I am going to win the WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
You know, Daniel, we've been asking the great WWE fans to send their questions in for you via Twitter this week. We're going to bring you some of those now. The first one comes from Believe in the Ado, who says, well, who do you think is the biggest threat to win the WWE World Heavyweight title match tonight?
Well, I have three thoughts on this. One, John Cena. Two, maybe Randy Orton. But three, somebody who I think is incredible, Roman Reigns.
Our next Twitter question comes to us from Don't Back Down A-N-M. And this person asks, when Stephanie said on Monday Night Raw, you were no longer champ due to neck injuries, how did you honestly feel?
Quite honestly, I felt disrespected because they didn't even bother to tell me. They didn't even call me. I found out just like everybody else. But I understand, though, because none of them can actually beat me, so they have to strip me of the titles. But one thing that did bother me is how smug Stephanie McMahon was when she came out here and said it. And one day, somebody's gonna come out here and wipe that smile off her face.
Can it be? Oh my goodness, look, Kane!
I'm looking and I'm seeing. What's he doing here?
He's the most inspirational superstar in WWE history. That's what he's doing out here. If anyone can inspire
Daniel Bryan, I'm not going to knock you, but why is he interrupting?
And that's why he's no superstar.
Daniel? Hey, buddy. I've been listening to everything you had to say backstage, and I understand you can't compete tonight. Gosh! That's got to be such a pain in the neck! But listen, life isn't about the destination. It's about the journey. And no, you might not be able to climb that ladder tonight. But you can still climb the ladder of life and make your way back to the top. All you have to do is believe.
That was awesome.
Bo, I appreciate your concern. I really do. But, it feels to me like you're acting like a boner.
That was awesome.
And I think I pretty much speak for everyone here when I say this. Bo, leave.
Hey, that's not the way you say it.
Oh, that was good.
It's unbelievable. No, it's believe as if you leave.
Yes.
Bo,
please.
Sector 1, sick around the building.